Great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Michigan State Spartans and the Michigan Wolverines. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
Two talented young men are featured at the power forward spot. They usually play hard and play well, so keep an eye on them.
Tonight we've got an interesting matchup at the small forward spot. Number 21 is a kid that has every intention of putting it in your face when he gets near the rim.
His counterpart tonight is a guy that likes to lead by example for his team.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Dick, if you were coaching either one of these teams, what would your points of emphasis be?
First off, spread out the attack. It helps when everyone appears to be a scoring threat. Secondly, they can't be afraid to juggle their lineup, especially when players are fatigued. Make subs if that's the case. Finally, get low and block out. When the shot goes up, they can't give up any offensive rebound.
A little two-man action. On the dribble, gives it up. And on the shot clock, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Charles receives the pass with a good look. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
That I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball. Dump it inside.
The jumper strokes the two. Vincent handles the pass. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. He's in the clear. Jumper won't go. Up and in. Here comes the ball screen. For two. He gets the foul and the layup will count, Dick.
Hey, way to play strong, my man. Way to play strong.
With the free throw. Count it. They've got him trapped. Escapes some trouble and makes a pass up. He may be in some trouble here. Passes it out of the trap. Pushes it up.
Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Rod.
Great composure to pass it out of the trap. Bucket. The Spartans have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
Goes up for two. The lane. Take a look at this highlight, courtesy of Pontiac. Gave it up. Ten on the shot clock.
Another turnover created by great D, Brad.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He grabs the board. Donovan. Donnelly handles the pass. On the outside, they've got a player spotting up on the three. They work the perimeter. Tries for two, way off target. Well, here's a look at the tempo for both teams tonight, Dick.
You know, it's crucial, Brad, that both teams stick to their style of play. If not, the chances of them winning definitely decreases.
Today he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He takes the open jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Number 32 gets the pass. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Up and in. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Jackson handles the pass. Kicks it out for two. The land.
Look at that spacing.
For the he blocks the shot. Up and in. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Rose receives the ball. Looking for a good shot. Ten on the shot clock. Ball goes out of play. On the shot clock. Rose receives the pass. Goes up with a shot. Off the mark. Coach providing some additional offensive instruction to his team. And a momentary look from three-point land. And the ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
On the shot clock. Now trying to feed the low block. Blocks the shot. The land. Looking for a good shot. Or they get that rejected. Up and in. Howard receives the ball. Good for two. They'll work it around the arc.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
There's the tempo for the game thus far.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Ten seconds left on the shot clock. Tries for two.
The lay-in.
The Spartans prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times, and then really settling in the half court at other times.
You know, balanced teams will definitely give you a combination of the two styles. Some teams will play up-tempo on offense and be half-court oriented at the defensive end. Other balanced teams may play in the half court offensively and really look to pressure their opponents in the full court. Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
The Spartans will play up-tempo at one end and in the half court at the other end. Wouldn't you agree, Dick?
They try to really get balance in that. They'll get some points with tempo by creating a little fast pace and then slow it down and executing their half-court set, getting high-percentage shots.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Brad, before the game, both coaches and players said they were looking forward to tonight's matchup. Whose weaknesses will be exposed and who will really step up, guys?
Thanks, Erin. Thanks, EA, our third member of our team, providing that additional insight. First go around tonight, Dick.
I'll tell you, the offense doesn't miss a beat when this guy comes in.
King handles the pass. They've got him right where they want him, Dick. King may have escaped one there. Rose handles the pass. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
If he keeps this up, he may collapse. His teammates must pick it up.
The small forward takes the feed. On the outside. He gets the rejection. 10 seconds to put it up. Perfectly executed.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
On the dribble, gives it up. From right at the circle, buries the deuce. Charles receives the pass. Works the perimeter.
Spacing's so important, get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Seconds on the clock. Looks at the three. Goes. Working it around the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. Up and in. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
The chanting continues.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
For the bucket, goes up for two. The lay-in. Gave it up. He rejects it. Handles the feed, the fadeaway. He misses the fadeaway. Well, I think the coach is going to have to make some changes here, Dick. The players are starting to look really tired out there.
Up and inside.
He passes it out of the trap. Jump hook from the low block.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Moving it around the perimeter. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Going to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. They still don't score. Kicks it out. Charles handles the feed. He makes the block.
Rejected!
Number five going in for the first time tonight.
He will give this defense a different kind of threat at this position. Smart move.
The power forward with the ball.
Dump it inside.
They get an open look for three. Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. For two. Up and in. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
The small forward receives the pass. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Ten on the shot clock. Number one with the ball. He gets the bucket. Takes the pass in the paint. The lay-in. Now they work it around the perimeter. They get an open three. He makes the shot. The power forward takes the pass. On the outside. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. That tight defense forces a 5-second call. Gave it up. The power forward takes the pass. They work the perimeter. Picks off the pass.
Opportunity for 2-for-1.
Shot clock. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Number one handles the feed and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
At the end of the first half, the Spartans trail by one. Well, let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. One half of basketball is finished, Dick. What about those points of emphasis?
I think they've done an insufficient job so far and do not seem prepared. We covered some important points during the pregame, and I don't think they've achieved any of them. They must do a much better job in the second half.
Okay, there you have it. One more half of basketball remains, and we'll see how the teams address these points of emphasis. Vincent checks back in.
Hey, yes, sometimes that quick breather can be the difference, Brad.
Dick, we're heading into the second half in our player matchup. It's going about the way we thought it would.
Well, they're really doing a great job. Both guys getting good shots, really making them count, and really their teammates are getting them the ball at the right time.
Michigan shot lights out from the floor in the first half.
I'll tell you, they executed exactly the way the coaching staff envisioned in their game plan. Huge credit goes to the players for making it happen on the floor.
Up and in. kicks it out. Tries for two. 10 seconds on the shot clock. The small forward gets the ball. What a reaction!
Hey, that reaction says it all. These fans are ecstatic, Brad.
The shooting guard receives the ball.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
For two, perfectly executed.
Look at that spacing.
Up to make the block. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how the dribbler uses the screen is important in a pick and roll situation.
The point guard, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Looking for a good shot. There's a slam. Receives the ball. They work it around the perimeter. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
A snail's pace, Brad. That's the tempo of this game. But if that's your philosophy, so be it.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Switch up. 10 seconds with the block. The point guard takes the feed. Tries for two. The lay-in. On the dribble, gives it up. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For two, perfectly executed. Looking for a good shot. Go in, go in, go in, go in, go in, go in. 10 on the shot clock. Fed the low block. Turnaround jumper. He gets the board. Donnelly handles the pass. Gave it up for the bucket. Up and in. Check out the replay, Dick. Definitely worth being part of our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Talk about highlight material, Mr. Nessler. That's a strong candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
They'll work it around the arc. 10 on the shot clock. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Goes up for two. The lane. The power forward takes the feed.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Ten on the shot clock. He takes the board. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
That stat doesn't surprise me, Brad. The pace of the game has been pretty slow.
On the outside.
Great pass out of the trap, Brad.
A little two-man action. On the dribble, gives it up. Turnaround jumper. The perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Makes an outstanding block. Up and in. Working it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. The Spartans have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
With a great block.
Up and inside.
Bucket doesn't go. Jackson receives the ball. Gave it up. He unloads a three. Makes the shot.
Defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Cross court. Pull up jumper, left side.
In and out. Ooh. Tough luck.
Moving it around the perimeter. Ten seconds to put up a shot. Goes up for two. And off the mark. The point guard with the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. Hurries it to beat the clock. Knocks down the two. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it from where you are, but I can hear it clearly. The coach is stressing to his team, go inside, go inside. They've been effective in this area all night long. What an asset to have.
I think she's right about that, Richie.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, if you have a great post play, you got a chance really to win.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
He blocks the shot. King handles the feed. Gave it up. He launches the bomb. No good from the field. The layup. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad, the player matchup has been our focus tonight, and he's been effective because his teammates are finding him in the right spot, and he's knocking down all his shots, guys.
Aaron Andrews, always close to the action. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play.
For the bucket. Up and in. With a jump hook.
I'll tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Hey, they're gonna have to watch that. Fatigue will make players do some silly things.
They're working around the perimeter. For two, and the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Cross court. Seconds showing on the shot clock. The shooting guard handles the pass. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
The shooting guard receives the ball. Dickey's gonna go up strong.
Oh, that's a terrific post play. Didn't waste any time attacking the basket.
And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
The power forward handles the feed. For the deuce. Dick, this is how you beat a team on the boards.
Exactly, and they're beating them on the boards fundamentally. Boxing out, hip hugs, you name it.
Dump it inside.
Ten on the shot clock. On the dribble, gives it up. Gets it to go. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Seconds to shoot. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Pulls it down.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
Tries for two. Rims out. How can you not love this game and the hoopla and fanfare that goes along with it?
It's crazy in here, Brad.
He hits it. Well, here's a look at the tempo for both teams tonight, Dick.
You know, it's crucial, Brad, that both teams stick to their style of play. If not, the chances of them winning definitely decreases.
That's a great defensive effort being all over the ball. They get the 5-second call. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He takes the three. No good. The small forward with the ball. Kicks it out. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
On the outside. He shoots from right of the circle. He doesn't get the hoop. Riley handles the pass. They work the perimeter.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
There's no fooling him. He gets the block in the post.
Look at him control the paint, Mr. Nesla. Get that stuff out of here, man.
Look at that spacing.
Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Well, here's a look at the tempo for both teams tonight, Dick.
You know, it's crucial, Brad, that both teams stick to their style of play. If not, the chances of them winning definitely decreases. Hey, Brad, he finishes this one off the transition.
Time out on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick with limited time remaining. The coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Well, the highs and lows of coaching, that's what you call it here, Dick.
Hey, you've got that right. You can be on cloud nine one day and the next day in the dumps. I've said it before, you've got to have thick skin to be in this business.
It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
Kicks it out. He shoots from the top of the circle.
They're having a rough time getting them to drop, Brad. They should take it to the basket and get some easy hoops.
The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
And yet another foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Michigan is in the bonus. And the clock stopped with a foul. Steps to the line for the freebie. Makes the front end of the one and one. Second shot, good. Timeout on the floor. There's no substitute for a timeout at this point of the game, is there, Dick?
There sure isn't, Brad. Anything can happen on any possession, and the game can swing back and forth in a heartbeat. It's good if your team can get a minute to regroup and talk things over.
I look for something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
Receives the ball, dumps it in. Now the turnaround jumper. The friendly bounces aren't going their way at the moment, Dick.
They need to get some easier looks, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the shot. Second shot, no good. With the big shot. What are your final thoughts regarding some of our points of emphasis earlier in the game, Dick?
Those points of emphasis are based on the team's style of play. Delivering on all, if not most of those points, should help secure the victory. Understanding your team's strengths and weaknesses is so important, Brad. I can't emphasize that enough.
You've got to know your strengths and weaknesses, and if you don't, it often results in losses. I don't know about you, Dick, but I think today's Pontiac game-changing performance was obvious out there on the court. Dick, you look back, it was a great matchup. We expected it to be, and it turned out to be everything we'd hoped for.
I'll tell you one thing. The team has really responded as a unit, and they've taken advantage of the abilities of their stars.
Michigan wins the game.
They'll be happy to walk away with a victory from such an